How do you rank the great guitar players of all time? Is Hendrix number one? Who's up there with him?
Yeah, I think Hendrix would probably be number one. I mean, there's so many great guitar players, and each one of them respects the other one so very much. You know, Jimi Hendrix was, like I said earlier, I mean, his... I don't know where he learned to do what he did. I don't know where anyone learns that. It's kind of like, you know, Robert Johnson leaving Memphis for a day and coming back to the greatest guitar player in the world, selling his soul to the devil at the crossroads. I don't know about how Jimmy exactly did it, but he had such a foundation of pure guitar technique and understanding of harmony and melody.
You have a guitar coming out.
I do indeed. I have, well, this guitar is the first prototype that I can't believe Gibson has chosen to recreate my 1960 Les Paul. When I first moved to Los Angeles in 1968, I was a big fan of the Mothers and Frank Zappa, so I was sporting a huge Gibson Super 400, you know, it's the greatest thing in the world for me. I loved it. It's fantastic. My band, we wound up being the first group to rehearse at Studio Instrument Rentals. Was a brand new company then. They were strictly renting instruments. It was my band in one room and Crosby, Stills, and Nash in the other room. And then the next week it was Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young there. And all of a sudden, this room was, the walls were covered with guitars. I'd never seen that. You know, I came to LA with a guitar, you know. I got my first acoustic here, you know. I didn't even know what an acoustic was, you know. A jazz player, rock and roll player. So there's this room full of beautiful guitars. And I knew I wanted a Les Paul again. So I asked Steven, I said, would you consider selling one of them? He goes, yeah, sure. He says, let's switch rooms tonight. You know, you guys rehearse in there, we'll rehearse in your room, and just take your pick, find one you like. It came down to, at the end of the night, it was this beautiful Sunburst, or the black three pickup. Both of them had Bigsby's on them, which I loved. And I wound up choosing this one because the 1960 neck is really thin this way, very thin. Most Les Pauls are about out to here, the chunk, which for my hand, I'm never comfortable on that, but as soon as my hand went around this neck, it was over for me. I went, that's the most, it's invisible in your hand. It's just beautiful. So, and it was brighter. It had more treble to it than the black one. So I chose this one. Wound up getting some money together and gave Steven a check for it. And
do you remember what you paid?
Yeah, I remember exactly what I paid. I paid $350 for it. $350 for this 1960 Sunburst. And one of the funny moments in the years was I was doing a session for Graham Nash one day, and Steven came in and said he'd forgotten about it. And he's looking at me, he's going, I want to know who sold you that guitar, man, because, you know, whoever sold you that stole it from me. And I'm going, oh, really? You sold it to me. Personally, you sold it to me. I handed you a check. He goes, is that right? Oh, yeah, that's right. So, oh, man, so we were laughing about that.
Wasn't
for about
the first
a year.
Time he missed it.
Yeah. So I've always cherished this guitar, and I used it on every record I played for, you know, countless years.